Hi, and welcome to a whattabletpc.com overview of Android 4.0 on a tablet PC. It's the Android Ice Cream Sandwich release, and what we're going to do today is quickly give you an overview of some of the new features, the main features with this release. So you'll notice on the lock screen you've got a couple of different options now. You can either unlock the tablet or jump straight to the camera. What I'm going to do first of all is to show you unlock the tablet and you go straight into the home screens here. But if you had other apps open at the time you locked it down, you jump to those. And actually, to give you an example, I'm just going to quickly jump into the camera app, and you can see straight away it takes us into the app where you can take some video or take some pictures. Now, also with this release, you've got some quite nice refinements and improvements to the interface. So we've got a slightly different font that's a bit easier to read on the tablet. And generally, we've got some nice polish to the operating system. So for example, we've got a multitasking kind of bar here, which quickly jumps you through the apps you've got open. Before, you had a little cross you had to tap on, which was a bit fiddly to use. Now you just swipe these and you can get rid of them pretty quickly. So that's fairly straightforward. Also, we've got the introduction of folders. So for example, I've set up a folder here. You'll see you've quickly got the games already in this one. I'm just going to quickly take these out so I can show you how it's all put together. It's largely drag and drop, as you'll see from the moves that I'm making here. Let's put it out. So this is what you'd have on a kind of a screen if you had lots of apps, widgets, etc. that were a bit messy. Now you can put them into folders. So say, for example, I just want to grab a few of these apps and put them into one folder. Let's first of all, you press on one, keep your finger on it, drag it across to another one, and it creates a folder. And straight away, you can see there's two apps within that one. If I click out of it, grab another app, hold it down, drag it in. Similarly, I grab another one here, hold it down, put it in, and we create this much bigger folder. You can also rename these folders so they're a bit easier to locate quickly. So that's just some games. Quite easy again to undo those, as I showed you when I was just playing around with this. Other improvements, we've got an enhancement to the gallery application. You've got a nice kind of interface here for selecting your videos or pictures. I'm going to quickly jump into this image here and I'll show you some of the new effects that have come in here. So for example, you can jump onto edit, and this is all new, so you have the option to play around with photos, change some of the effects to the photos. That one's quickly jump that over to black and white. You can quickly jump onto other options, change saturation, all those sort of things. Jump it onto sepia, etc. Similarly, then you've got other things like face glow, face tan, other kind of effects you can straighten, change the photo around a bit, and just generally play around with it, get it exactly as you want it. So that's the kind of edit function within the gallery app. You've also got some enhancements to the camera app. So here I'm currently sat on a on taking still pictures. There's also the option to take some other video or panoramic view, which is where it stitches lots of pictures together to create a longer view. You've got the option to do a zoom there, jump onto the settings, and you've got settings specific to still camera. So you've got things like flash mode, white balance, exposure, scene mode, camera settings, etc. Some of that was around in the previous version. What's new for the this version for Ice Cream Sandwich though is on the video camera stuff here. We've got things again like FX that you can add as you're going through taking video, various bits and pieces there to enhance and play around with your video. You've got other settings like time lapse, video quality, torch mode, white balance, and various other different settings. So that's the camera app. Also now, other sort of improvements are things like the on-screen keyboard. So if I jump into Polaris Office here, what I'm going to do quickly is just set up a new file. So that's the Word file. Up comes the keyboard. It's a slightly different design. You get a bit of haptic feedback as you are typing. Oops. I'm just going to type the name of this tablet. it's much better at catching your kind of your taps on the keyboard, and also the kind of suggestion tool is a lot more intelligent than it was previously. As you can see, you can actually get some reasonable typing speeds on this, and it's just much more accurate in general. Now, if I jump back out of this, let's show you. There's a range of Google apps that are already stuck in a folder on the bottom here. I've got a few widgets, etc., selected. I'll show you now the kind of new apps and widgets screen. So here we've got apps and widgets in one area. Apps, fairly easy to drag stuff on out of here and get it into the one of the home screens. So I've just again tapped on it, hold it down, you drag it in, and it snaps in there. Similarly, on the widgets, you can just select a widget. Let's just select some bookmarks, pull that in here. Oops, there you go, it's on. Of course, with these widgets, certain specific ones, of course, you can carry on resizing. So you just hold it down, resize the widget, make it a bit bigger to your needs. So that's the kind of main features for this new Android 4.0 update. I'll be back in future videos to give you a lot more detail on what Android is capable of. We've also got some other reviews at the site whattabletpc.com, so pop over there if you want to check out some of those reviews. And if you like this video, press the like or subscribe to the YouTube channel, and we'll bring you some more fairly soon.